So, the first of the medal matches in the next category, the women's 63 kilo category, and it'll be between the Mongolian Masumjagul Bayabat and Renata Zakova of the Czech Republic.
Bayabat came in here with five previous matches. Well, Zakova came in here with four previous matches.
Mongolia always a strong nation at judo. Got the throw in this time for Wazari.
The Mongolians just looking to kill time there on the ground by being active. As long as she appears active, they're not going to stop the clock.
Well, with a second on the clock, the medal is going to the Mongolian. Masumjagul Bayabat of Mongolia wins the bronze medal with a Wazari against Zakova of the Czech Republic. Zakova just never felt she managed to quite get into the match quite as much as Bayabat. Bayabat control things from the start. Who will get the second bronze in this category? Camilla Badarova of Russia, or will it be Yi Ju Han of Korea? Russian on the left-hand side of white. Camilla Badarova up against Yi Ju Han of Korea for the second bronze medal match in the 63 kilo category. When you watch top-level judo, often you realize that the fighters have fought each other so many times. Another foot sweep. Wazari.
The Ashibarai, advancing foot sweep from the Russian. As I said earlier, you've got to really watch out for those.
Badarova, former silver medalist in the European Under-23 Championships. She's about to become a bronze medalist at the 30th Universiade here in Naples. Camilla Badarova of Russia wins it with a Wazari.
The winner of the bronze medal for Russia.
And that is Russia's second medal of the day. Second bronze medal, too. The gold medal match now in the women's 63 kilo category. It's Namakota of Japan against Gekke Vandenberg of the Netherlands, with the Dutch athlete in the blue. This will be Netherlands' first medal in the judo here at the Universiade in Naples.
Definitely a lot of leg techniques could help her because she has that longer reach. She could get better grips, grip more quickly because she has a longer reach. And then when she gets them, she could use her legs for Osotogari or Ouchigari. But it was Kota who started with the first Osotogari, taking down Vandenberg. Not for a score, but enough to start a transition on the ground. Vandenberg does a very smart thing to trap her opponent's both feet. Kota's working hard.
To hold the Japanese legs as well.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, but she's got the hold on.
It starts Yuko Shiogatami. Side four corner hold.
Grab the legs. So the hold is off.
Well, she has to actually cross her feet once she trapped the leg in order for the pin to be broken. She only had the top part of her leg and not the bottom part.
So the hold counted, and it was for long enough to give Nana Kota of Japan the win by Ippon and the gold medal here at the Universiade. So in this case, size didn't matter.
No. But she could have used those legs to trap her opponent if she had a little bit more time, but she didn't have enough time to escape. So good work to Kota, as well as to her opponent.
Second gold medal of the day for the Japanese. Their third gold medal overall here in the judo, 30th Universiade.